Hi, my name's Ankit.
And my name's Ellie, and welcome back to the channel.
In this video, we're going to cover how to describe a rash. And this is a skill you're going to use time and time again when you become a doctor.
We hope you enjoy the video, subscribe for more, and click the link below for access to all of our dermatology notes for free.
So, let's get started on how to describe a rash.
You might not think that this is an important skill, but you'll be surprised at the number of consultations that involve a dermatology problem. Knowing the terms for how to classify a skin lesion and how to present that can really help yourself in diagnosing it and then referring that to others. Plus, it also makes you sound professional, which is a good thing. So, in this lesson, we're going to focus on three things. First, we're going to focus on how to classify lesions. So this means using terms such as patch, plaque, and nodule. And second, how to describe these lesions using the 7 S's model. Words like patch and nodule are just one of those 7 S's. We also want to know where it is, how big it is, and what it looks like. And finally, we're going to have a go at some examples. We'll describe them using the 7 S's method, and then give you an example of how to present them yourself. So, let's get started.
It's really important that you learn the definitions of these dermatological terms. And this is because so many medical students waste so much time trying to describe these lesions in many words when just one word would suffice. For example, instead of saying a flat region with no textural difference, you could just use the word macule. So, what are the key terms that you really need to know? So the first are macules and patches, and these are flat, impalpable areas of skin with no areas of elevation or depression, but they can have a change in surface color. So we use the word macule if it's less than 0.5 centimeters, and the word patch if it's more than 0.5 centimeters. It's important that we describe macules and patches by their color, and we split this up into 4 main categories. So you have hyperpigmented lesions, which are darker in color than the surrounded skin. You then have hypopigmented areas, which are lighter in color than the surrounding skin. Then we have specific words like erythematous, which means red, and purpuric, which are purple areas of skin which don't blanch when pressed. The next terms you need to know is papule and plaques. And these are well circumscribed, solid elevations of skin with no fluid underneath. Again, we're going to use the word papule if it's less than 0.5 centimeters and the word plaque if it's more than this. These are palpable and they can either be skin colored or, for example, erythematous or purpuric. The next key term is a cyst, which I'm sure you would have heard before. And what this is a hollow mass which is surrounded by a complete epithelium lining. These are well demarcated from the adjacent tissue and they can contain fluid. The next one that you'll commonly hear is a nodule. Now these are very similar to papules, but they're often centered deeper in the dermis. And the size is less than 0.5 centimeters. The next is a wheal, which is a rounded red plaque that typically disappears in about 24 hours. This is going to be part of the inflammatory response due to the release of histamine. So they're often characterized by dermal edema. The next group that we come onto are vesicles and bullae. And these are blisters which are full of clear serous fluid. Unlike cysts, they don't have a complete epithelial lining, which makes them less well demarcated from the surrounding tissue, such as cold sores, for example. Again, categorizing according to size, vesicles are less than 0.5 centimeters and bullae are larger than this. Next, we have pustules. Now, these are cavities which are full of pus and inflammatory cells. These can also be sterile or infected. And the last group is the fissures, erosions, and ulcers. And all these are, it's a group of lesions which differ by the extent that they penetrate through the epidermis. So the first is a fissure, which is a crack from the epidermis to the dermis. Then you have erosions, which is partial loss of the epidermis. And finally, you have ulcers, which is a full thickness loss of the epidermis. So we appreciate that must be a lot of information to take in, but I can guarantee if you learn these key terms, it'll make identifying any lesion much easier.
Now that you know the terms, let's have a go at describing the lesions in full. I used to find this really hard, as there was so much information to include. I start with trying to use the technical words, but then I would just get really muddled and then resort to using words like big and red, and then I'd just be guessing what it is. But then I realised, as with everything in medicine, it's good to have a systematic approach. Whenever you're describing a lesion, we advise you to use the following approach. First, it's sight. Where is it on the body? If it's a photo, we want to know what is the photo of, and if you can see another side to see what is normal for the person. At this point, we also want to know whether it's a single or multiple lesions. Second is shade. Tell the person if it is a pigmented lesion or not. Then be specific as to what the color is. Remember words like erythematous, it could be yellow, orange, or purpuric. Third is style. This is when you use the dermatological terms like patch and papule. If we take a break here, you should see how we can include all of this information in one sentence. For example, in this picture of a leg, I can see a pigmented macule. Four, size. And this is important for both diagnosis and management. If you can't measure it, have a guess and state that you would like to formally assess the size. Next is shape. And again, this is important to help narrow down the differentials. Here, you want to mention if it's symmetrical or asymmetrical. Point number six is the surface. Here, you want to mention the surface texture and whether it is smooth or rough. Also, you want to describe if it is scaly, moist, or dry. And the last point is the sides. Are they well-defined, are they regular, or is it really hard to tell? So with those seven S's, you've covered everything you need to know in order to describe a lesion well.
So we've learned the key terms and learned how to describe lesions. So let's put this into practice with some examples. So how would we describe this lesion using the seven S's method? Well, the first thing is the site is unknown. In terms of the shade, I'd say it's pigmented with many variations in color. In terms of the style, from the photo, it's hard to tell if it's raised. So we could say either a plaque or a patch. According to the size, it seems to be about 10 millimeters by 5 millimeters. But I'd say that I'd want to formally measure this. In terms of the shape, it's asymmetrical with an irregular shape. The surface looks smooth in the middle and slightly rough around the borders. And the sides are irregular borders which are clearly well defined. So putting this all together in a nice concise paragraph, I would say this is a photo of an unknown location of skin which shows a pigmented patch. It has variations in color and is sized about 10 millimeters by 5 millimeters. It's asymmetrical, smooth in the middle, slightly rough around the edges, and has irregular borders. So my clinical impression is a malignant melanoma.
Let's have a look at a second case. On first impression, this appears to be much harder. However, by using our method, let's see how we can describe it really clearly and neatly. First, the site. There are multiple lesions on the dorsum of the hands, concentrated at the fingertips. In terms of the shade, they're depigmented. And as for the style, I would describe this as multiple patches. Now, looking at the size, they range from a few millimeters to large, almost covering the full thumb. The shapes are irregular, the surface is smooth with no textural difference to normal skin, and it has neat and well-defined edges. Now, putting this all together, I'm looking at a photo of the dorsum of both hands. The photo shows multiple depigmented patches of skin concentrated on the fingertips. These range from a few millimeters to large, covering almost all of the thumb, and the patches are irregular, smooth, and have well-defined edges. So, based on all of this, my clinical impression would be vitiligo. And it's as simple as that. So, we hope you found that useful. Again, we're really trying to pitch these videos at the level of knowledge we think you need at medical school.
So, next time you're on the wards, try this method of describing a rash and see how you get on. And just remember to click the link below, where you'll get access to all our dermatology notes for free.
If you liked our video, subscribe below, where we'll be releasing a new video with each clinical module. See you next time.